Okay guys, how many times have you wanted to order wheels for your car and you're scratching your head going, will those wheels fit my car? What are these numbers that I need to talk about? What is all this stuff? What is offset, backspacing, positive offset, zero offset, negative offset? How do I know that just because it's a 5-bolt pattern, it's going to fit my car? Well, those are all valid questions, especially if you are looking at building a hot rod, or you're changing out hubs, or you just want some different cars for your, or different wheels for your car. I'm going to show you some stuff that might help you. Now, the first thing we want to look at is what we call a bolt circle template. I've got one right here. Okay, as you can see, this is from Master Power. There's their number right there. 888-351-8781. And I probably picked this one up at a car show. They probably had a display or something, but it's just a little paper template with holes in it. As you can see, it's got the 4-inch bolt pattern, bolt circle pattern indicated on it, the 4.5 and the 4 3/4. Now, what I want to show you here is some options to that. This is really a hard thing to use. Now, you can always measure between your bolt holes. So let's say this is one bolt hole right here, and this is another bolt hole. You take a tape measure and you measure from the outside of this wheel stud down to the center of the other wheel stud, and that would give you your 4-inch, 4.5-inch, or 5-inch, and then you would say it's either 4 bolts or 5 bolts. Seems pretty simple, and it is. It's not too bad, but tapes wiggle, you're going over the hub sometimes, so these bolt circle templates really help. And this one's paper, very small hub center on that, and it's a use and lose application. I wouldn't recommend this for a go-to at all. I would recommend a set of these. These are bolt circle templates, okay? And this one, as you can see, I told you on my hot rod, it's 4.5. Right there's a 4.5 indicator. But when I put this on my wheel, the lug nuts go through the 4.5 hole. All 5 of them on here. It's 4.5. And people say, well, Ray, what if I want millimeter? What if I'm working in a millimeter? Well, we know that 4.5 inches is 114.3 millimeters. That's, you can ask Google that and it'll tell you that. So you would go with this second ring in my set, which is a millimeter ring. And I bet you if you put this on a 4.5-inch bolt circle template, it would come out right there at the 115. It would slide on at the 115, the 115 millimeter, all 5 of them. So Ray, what if I have a 4-lug and I don't have a 5-lug bolt? Well, you'd use the blue one in this kit. All right, this is for 4. This is for the 4. So, right? And this is for a 4-hole because it will only go on an axle with 4, a hub with 4 studs, wheel studs coming out of it. Okay? So this is actually a 6-lug template, so it's for your heavy-duty trucks, anything with a 6-hole bolt pattern. That's what this one is for. Now, these make it look a lot more complicated than it is, because in reality, your most common bolt patterns that you're going to find is indicated on here. So I got these from New Yankee Metal. You can look them up online. I think you can get these off of Amazon. I might even get these off of Amazon. I don't remember. But they're not that expensive. They're not very, I mean, for these tools, and these are a tool. These are gauges. You need them to do stuff, and you can just keep them, and you need them, you pull them out. And it takes the guesswork out of what you need to get. And if you've got a wheel that you're not sure will fit, use these. You can turn that wheel over and set them inside, just line them up until you get the holes right, and then you know what you're dealing with. These are worth the money, especially if you like cars and you like changing wheels, and if you're like me and you're forgetful sometimes. Now, let's talk about offset and back spacing. Now, offset measures from the mounting surface or the center line, the center where your wheel mounts, to the center line of the wheel. Back spacing is basically the distance between where your hub mounts to the wheel to the inside lip of the tire. So the back spacing is basically just the measurement from where your wheel bolts to your hub to the inside of the car, if you're looking in the fender. Okay, so imagine that this is a wheel. Okay, this is a wheel. The red would be the outside that you see when you're looking at the car. The blue would be the inside rim of your wheel inside the fender well. And the orange would be the mounting hub, where your wheel connects, where it bolts down to the hub of your car or the discs of your brakes or whatever. So backspacing is just measuring that blue part, right? The distance between where it's mounted to the inside of the wheel. Now, why is that important? Well, it's important if you need to clear brakes. If you don't want to rub the inside of your fender, you can just take a tape measure and measure that out, a yardstick or anything. And it's important for clearance, you know, if you need to clear those wheels. So let's talk about offset. Offset would be like the entire way this wheel sits on your car. Okay. So this wheel, if it has a positive offset, creates more back space. Okay. So when you have put on a wheel in your car, it's basically tuck. If you want to tuck your wheels in under the car fender, you want a positive offset, so the wheel tucks. Positive offset means that orange is closer to the red than it is the blue. A negative offset means that orange is closer to the blue side of the wheel than it is the red, so it's going in. So if you want a negative offset, was what you would use on like a four-wheel drive if you want the wheels to stick out a little bit out of that fender. A zero offset means that the wheel is set where the orange is center of the wheel. That mounting plate is in the center of the wheel. And sometimes that's what you want. So you have to look at your car and say, do I want this to be a positive offset? Meaning I want it to tuck. I want to tuck it in. In that case, you need to know how much room you have in that wheel well before you start tucking in with a positive offset. You may only want a positive offset of just a few centimeters. You know, you might not want a whole inch. You just might only want to tuck it in a little bit. And with that, you would work on those measurements and explain to your wheel manufacturer or wheel supplier exactly what you want, because you've already done the measurements of how I want it to stick out. Now you've got a 10 inch wide wheel, 8 inch. You can get all kinds of widths of your wheel. 8 isn't bad. 10's a little meaty. Anything above that, you're getting into really wide rubber. But that's all up to you. So the thing you want to remember is your positive offset is the tuck. How far do I want my wheels to tuck in? And is my backspacing going to clear the brakes, or is the backspacing going to push my wheel in there so deep that it's rubbing on the frame or something, the shocks or something inside that space? So it's just a little bit of basic math. You just look at the wheel width, you turn that wheel over face down on the ground, and you measure that backspacing if you need to. Say, okay, this is what I got. And if you got a wheel you can set up on your car, that's the best way to do it. But not always. Sometimes we see wheels when we're somewhere else and we want those wheels. They're pulling our trigger. And say you're at a show or something, and there's a guy that's got four wheels that you'd think would look really good on your car. It wouldn't hurt to have some of these in your trunk and check that wheel out and see if it's going to fit your car. There are tricks you can do that I don't really recommend. Spacers under high torque situations. Now, I argue this all the time. If you're running spacers on an ice cream cruiser, something you're not racing, it's not really a big beefed up hot rod, it's just a cool car, and you're not going to be twisting it, torquing it, and treating it rough, you can get by doing a few tricks with spacers. But it's better to buy the shoes that fit your feet than it is to wear your brother's shoes. So remember, negative offsets stick out. That's what you want to do on the four-wheel drives. You want to push that wheel out, or that wheel well. And that would work with the 10-inch and up width of a wheel. You want it to look meaty and aggressive. Positive offset, you want to tuck it in there with a positive offset. Say you want to put 22s on a bagger, and you want to drop those fenders down over that, those 22s. Well, you're going to need a real positive offset because you want a wide tire. You want a big round tire, but you also want them to clear that fender. You want to tuck them in there. So you want to tuck them in, and by tucking them in, you'll do that with a positive offset. Creates more backspace. Okay? Don't forget, you can Google all this stuff and study up on it yourself. I'm just telling you, this tool is a good tool to use. And tomorrow I'll go down and work on a hot rod a little bit. I've got the dash and everything I want to drop off, and that's what I'm doing this week. So that is the first lesson of this week.